In this video, let us discuss about instance. What is instance? SAP application servers will be installed after completion of database instance. Okay, here you see an instance is an administrative unit that combines SAP system components providing one or more services. The services provided by an instance are started or stopped together. We use a common instance profile to set parameters of all the components of an instance. Each instance has its own buffer areas. An instance runs on one physical computer, but there can be multiple instances on one computer. An instance is identified by the system ID, SID, and the instance number. The terms SAP instance and application server are often used synonymously. Let us look at this graphics so that you will understand in better way. Here, the SAP system is distributed into three layers. One is database layer. This is the database layer. And application layer. And presentation layer. So, in the application layer, actual processing will be done. Here, there are two computers, means three servers are available. One is computer A, another is computer B, another is computer C. Okay, the first computer, that is first server which you install, you should install central instance. Here central instance means inside this there is a central instance. The instance has its own number 00 and also central services. Central services are nothing but message server and NQ server. In the central instance, it will have some services. Services means it will have some processes. Those are all called work processes. Those are all the work processes will be started or stopped together. Okay, at a time we can stop all the work processes or stop all the work processes. So once this central instance is started, we can communicate or we can log on to SAP system. If this central instance is not started, we cannot log on to the SAP system. To log on to SAP system, you should have the central instance at application level. Then only any user can use SAP GUI to log on to SAP system. In backend, the database server should be available. Otherwise, the user information will not known by this central instance. Okay, let us take one more look at this paragraph. An instance is an administrative unit that combines SAP system components providing one or more services. Okay, let us see one of my SAP NetWeaver systems to understand what are all the services are combined in this particular administrative unit, that is instance. Just let me connect to my computer. See, in this computer I have installed two instances. One is central instance, another is dialog instance. In the central instance, if you expand the central instance here, if you click on process list, you should be able to see extra services, that is message service, and in the work processes table, NQ work process. So these two things are extra in central instance. So when you see this NQ work process or message service, you can consider that this particular instance is called central instance. And size of the box also little bit bigger than this box. And if you look at work processes table of dialog instance, just see all are dialog work processes and background work processes. So these are all the different types of work processes available in the SAP system to perform operations of user requests in the application server, application level. So these are all the work processes can be stopped or started together like this. For suppose if you right click here, you can stop it and you can start it. Okay. So that's why it is called as administrative unit. It can be stopped or started together. And each instance will have its number, that is instance number. Here you are looking at no 1. That means it is actually 01. And here there is a 0. That means it is 00. Even you can find out this information from the folder level, from computer C drive, USR, SAP. This is the system identifier of the SAP system, DEV. Double click on it. And here you can see two types of folders. This is one folder. This belongs to central instance. This belongs to dialog instance. Central instance has 00 number. Dialog instance has 01 number. Okay, in this way you can distinguish between different types of instances. Okay, let us continue the reading. When you install an SAP system, you already have the option of separating the processes at application level from those at database level. This means that the database for an SAP system can be installed and operated on a separate physical computer, separated from the instances of the SAP system. There is exactly one database for each SAP system. The database usually has the same system ID, DBID as the SAP system. So when you start the installation, you have the option of separating the processes at application level. That means we can install separate application server apart from database server. So that you can have the database in separate server and application server in separate server. Okay, in that way you can choose the option while starting the installation. Just let me give you brief idea about how it will looks like. If I start another installation here, so in the initial screen there is an option to select only the instance, that is application server. Okay, this is the initial screen I will get after double clicking on SAP Inst from the installation master. Just expand SAP Native 7.0, and in this SAP application server above, here on what database you are going to install, you have to choose the database type. And here there is a three options available, that is central system, distributed system, high availability system. So in the central system, if you select, so this will install everything in single server, that is database instance and central instance. Or you can also choose distributed system. Here you have the concept of separating each server, that means each process is to different servers, that is global host preparation, database instance, central instance. Here you are separating the instances into different servers. So once the server central instance is installed, next time onwards, like if you want to add more power to the existing SAP system, you can install dialog instance using software lifecycle options, application server, Oracle dialog instance. To install dialog instance, you should have already installed central instance. Without central instance, you can't perform dialog instance installation because it needs message server and enqueue to process further. I hope you understood a little bit about this instance concept, what is the characteristics of central instance, means how to identify the central instance, you understood. Okay, so let us continue further. And here the explanation about central instance. You see, the central instance of the SAP system is distinguished by the fact that it offers services that no other instance of the system offers. For the AS above, AS above means AS application server above, these are the message server and the enqueue work process. Message server and enqueue work process. For the AS Java, application server Java, we can recognize the central instance by the software deployment manager. If it is a AS Java type system, you can recognize a central instance by the software deployment manager. There is an option called software deployment manager when you install AS Java system. The central services instance provides central services of the AS Java, the message service and enqueue service. So particularly in AS Java, there is a concept of central services instance. It provides central services of the AS Java, the message service and the enqueue service. For the AS ABAP, these services can also be moved to ABAP central services instance. Even in AS ABAP also, application server ABAP also, you can move these services, that is enqueue service and message services, to the ABAP central services instance for high availability reasons. Okay, and all other instances of the system are typically called dialog instances. Whatever the extra instances you are going to install, those are all called dialog instances. If the central instance and the database are installed on the same computer, this is referred to as a central system. When you install database and central instance in the same system, it is called as a central system. So that's all about the explanation of instance, what is instance and characteristics of central instance and the dialog instance, database instance. Okay, if you do a lot of practice, you will understand this concept very clearly. Means you have to install different types of instances on your computer, so that you can understand, so you will not have any confusions in identifying instances. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching.